ain't got the change of a nickel. Ain't got no bounce in my shoe. Ain't got no fancy to tickle. I ain't got nothing but the blues. Ain't got no coffee that's perking. Ain't got no feelings to bruise. Don't have a dream that is working. I ain't got nothing but the blues. Swinging, the folks are singing. I just can't let my head down. Believe me, Pruitt, ain't nothing to it since my little baby left town. Ain't got no rest in my slumber. Got no winnings to lose. Don't have no telephone numbers. No, I ain't got nothing but the just like riding a bike. But I would just say I've done a lot of streaming shows, I've done quite a few though over the last year and a half, and I have to say that's a bit like riding a stationary bike. And so I'm now on a bike in traffic. And I'm glad I'm on it with you all. So I thought I would play some things that are, a bunch of these are not things that I've recorded yet, but I do plan to. And so some of these aren't on CDs, but they will be. This is called The Devil You Know. One of the foundational stories of the blues is the story of how Robert Johnson supposedly went to the crossroads and sold his soul to the devil to become a great guitar player. And Maybe you and I aren't Robert Johnson, but every day there is somebody out there offering us something that they think we want in exchange for some part of our souls, our integrity, our decency, our humanity, our caring for other people. If we would just give that up, or some part of it up, we can have this thing that we supposedly want. We are all down at the crossroads. The devil, you know, he's a regular guy. Well, could he be the devil when he meets you on your level and he looks you straight in the eye? Says you got nothing to hide. The devil, you know, he's a one-man show. Knows your every fear, says what you wanna hear. That anger is a good that grows, gives you new friends and foes. With the devil's touch, the little changes start to show. Don't you ever notice that faint orange glow from the fires below creeping in your soul? We're all going down to the crossroads. You want to help me with that line? We're all going down to the crossroads. Beautiful. Don't you get burned, there's still time to turn from the devil. The devil. Fine print is the finest. Hold on to your wallet, cause the numbers are falling and it's all coming up a big minus, sneaking up behind us. The devil, you know, the game that he's playing. He's a man of his word, long as you haven't heard most of what he's been saying. The predator always praying. Can't you feel the beads of sweat pouring off your brow? Like the tears of your better angels now, praying so hard for you to turn around. We're all going down to the crossroads. We surely are. We're all going down to the crossroads. Don't you get burned, there's still time to turn from the devil. The devil, you know. A real good story about us and them, and remember when, all for the greater glory, all the points he's scoring. The devil, you know, wants to take up your time. Well, he ain't the first, the last, or the worst of the devils of his kind. So don't you pay him no mind. With the devil's touch, the little changes start to show.
Don't you ever notice that faint orange glow from the fires below creeping in your soul? We're all going down to the crossroads. We sure are. We're all going down to the crossroads. Don't you get burned. There's still time to turn from the devil. Well, he feels like a friend, and that's why you bend towards the devil. Don't you get burned, there's still time to turn from the devil.
Events unfold with a mixture of horror and frustration. And I think the hardest part, of course, was trying to somehow grapple with the fact that our fellow citizens were the ones putting us in danger. And I think that's the hardest thing to swallow, I think, and to process, and to somehow handle without just resorting to, you know, letting it eat away at your heart. To not think the worst of people. And so this song is sort of about that struggle. And the struggle to be humble in the face of things that don't make any sense. What if the truth is too bitter to take? If my story is all fake, but it makes me feel okay. Does it matter? What if a lie holds the sun up in my sky? I look myself right in the eye and say I'm doing fine, long as the world falls into line. I tell myself is all wrong. What if it's me and I can only sing one song? What if the story I tell myself is all wrong? What if I see
causes me no shame. And the rest I hope will stay excluded from the frame. Can I bear to take some blame? What if the story I tell myself is all wrong? What if it's me and I can only sing one song? What if the story I tell myself?
The title of which was, This Is Not Propaganda, Adventures in the War on Reality. And Pomerantsev follows basically disinformation campaigns all over the world. And he goes to the Philippines, where he finds an amazingly evolved ecosystem of fake websites and fake news sites. And part of how Rodrigo Duterte got to be president there was tapping into this disinformation ecosystem. The Philippines was sort of on the leading edge of developing that. He travels to the Ukraine and documents, of course, the whole Russian disinformation campaign. But one of the things that he documented, which was so striking to me, was that the Russian war in the Ukraine isn't being fought to seize territory or to control, to regain land that they supposedly lost. The sole purpose of the war is to provide heroic images of the boys, you know, in uniform, waging war, so that they can broadcast that back to the rest of Russia and rally support for the regime there. That's really the sole purpose of the war. The war is a completely, it's a propaganda exercise. There's actually no military or political objectives other than that. And when I understood that from reading the book, I realized that that kind of cynical propaganda gestures had now come to our country, of course. So, you know, many of the policies that we saw in the last administration had no actual policy value. They weren't designed to solve any actual problem. They were simply elaborate propaganda gestures. So this is, among other things, an information war that we are in.
Thank you.
which way is up? It's hard to know. Why should I trust the one who lies the most? They say we need a strong man to steer the ship to shore. It's just the latest propaganda in the information war. What about the truth? Let the record show. Someone stood for right, and history will know. We tried to set the stage to end the dark age of the information war. This rotating cast of people that Sunny Oaks has asked to be part of these concerts, and many of you have attended some of those concerts. So I've added another one of Phil's tunes to my repertoire here. I thought I would share it with you. This is my first time sharing it in person with anybody. I had considered singing this song a few years ago, and then I just thought I couldn't really find my way into it. And then, of course, everything has changed. And like a lot of Phil's writings, this one really feels, it always feels relevant, but particularly in light of the terrible events of January 6th and the events in Afghanistan, and there are echoes of all these things that seem to be called up in this tune. This is called The War Is Over. Silent soldiers on a silver screen, framed in fantasies and drugged in dreams. Unpaid actors of the mystery. The mad director knows that freedom will not make you free. And
what's that got to do with me? I declare the war is over. It's over. It's over. Drums are drizzling on a grain of sand. Fading rhythms of a fading land. Show your courage in the proud parade. Trust your leaders where mistakes are almost never made. And they're afraid that I'm afraid. I'm afraid the war is over. It's over, it's over. Angry artists waving angry signs. Use their vision just to blind the blind. Poison players in a grisly game. One is guilty and the other gets to point the blame. Pardon me if I refrain. I declare the war is over. It's over. Find the flag so you can wave goodbye. By the end, maybe even treason might be worth a try. This country is too young to die. You only are what you believe.